Before I pay my tributes to Naresh and Shyam, I would like to show a short PowerPoint presentation on Ayuka cosmology. Now, you may think from this title that I am talking about all the work done in cosmology in Ayuka from 1988 to 2009, but that is not the case. I assure you, it is a cosmological model telling you how Ayuka has evolved from its birth in 1988. And I have modeled it on the standard Big Bang cosmology. Although you know that I am not a believer in Big Bang, I found this analogy very amusing. So let me share it with you. So first, we start with the creation of Ayuka in the year 1988, December 29, when Professor Yashpal inaugurated or unveiled the foundation stone of Ayuka. Here you see Professor Yashpal, followed by me and Professor Takole, who was the then Vice Chancellor of Pune University. So we can say that this was the origin of Ayuka. Followed by this was an era of quantum uncertainty, quantum fluctuations, as in the standard cosmology. What you see here is Gole Bungalow, which was a space which contained space allotted to Ayuka in the form of a small room, which you see on the right hand side of the building. You see one window in that room and steps coming down. Now, why I said uncertainty in the early days was because the room was very small and we had seating capacity for only half a dozen people. So if there were more people in the room, then some of them had to move out and sit on the steps outside. And it was not certain who will get the seating place at the time concerned. So this was the condition under which we worked in the early 1989 onwards. Then let us start with the first particle in this universe, which is the primordial Planck particle, that is our Naresh Dadich, whom you see standing in the empty grounds where Ayuka buildings were to come up. Then came the later epoch when we had the quark gluon plasma. So in the first column you see the quarks, which were the four scientists who were working there: myself, Naresh Dadich, Ajit Kembhavi and Sanjeev Dhurandhar. These were the first members in the academic stream. But our work was made easier if we were quarks. The quarks need gluons to attach them together to make them work. So these gluons were the second column. You see the support administration and scientific staff. We have Mrs. Malegaonkar, who ran the library, Dr. Chela Turai, who coordinated our academic programs, and Lata Shankar, who looked after all the visitors and travel arrangements. Without them, we would not have been able to function in those early days. Then finally, there were three students. These are the leptons, the light particles, who joined us in 1989 in spite of the rather primitive arrangements we had for them. So here we have Tarun Saurdeep, Kanti Jotania and Devi Prasad Dwari. As you know, not all leptons weigh the same. So the same thing happened about these students. Well, we progressed with our buildings and Ayuka was finally dedicated when the buildings were completed in December 1992. This is when we can say we had the era of nuclear synthesis, when the nuclei were formed in the Big Bang universe. This was done for us. The dedication was performed by Professor Chandrasekhar from Chicago, and we really enjoyed that particular occasion. Then started the large-scale structure, the growth of IOKA, and as you are aware, we started in a small way. After the Gole Bungalow, we had our own building for the first time, and this is Aditi Shed, which is still existing today in the form of a creche and other uses. You see at the bottom right corner the picture of Professor Srikantan, the retired director of Tata Institute of Fundamental Research. We were fortunate to have him around when we started digging for constructing the Aditi Shed, and he initiated our digging process. So we have a very good association with Professor Srikantan. Then finally for me came the last scattering surface, which was when I handed over my director's keys to Naresh Dadish, my successor, who took over as director from me in July 2003. Why do I call it last scattering surface? This is because, as you know, when you are a director, you are scattered from wherever you are going by various distractions. There may be administrative issues, there may be letters from UGC to answer, there may be sudden visitors coming in, all kinds of things. And so there are distractions which you want to handle as you go further. So your path is never very smooth. This is like the primordial photon, which in the early days, early times of the universe, was scattered frequently, but later on, after this so-called last scattering surface, it began to move smoothly without any scattering. So likewise, after I handed over charge to Naresh Dadhich, I suddenly felt great relief that I was now going to progress in a very uninterrupted manner. And after I left the charge in the hands of Naresh, things went on in a very smooth fashion again. And what is more, there was acceleration, as if you had dark energy. So there were many instances of progress made by IOKA in the post-2003 times. You see here the completion of the Giravali Observatory, then the progress made in virtual observatory, then we joined the SALT, the Southern African Large Telescope, and now we are even looking to a much bigger system, joining in an international collaboration for an ultra-large telescope. So all these things are telling us that IOKA is in an acceleration mode, and many things will happen on the observational as well as theoretical front. Well, I will conclude my presentation, and as you may have gathered, Naresh Dadhich was the key person in the very early stages to start the working of IOKA, and I greatly owe the success of IOKA to him. About Shyam, I should say one sentence which will explain how important his contribution has been. When I was looking for instrumentation expert, I was told to contact Shyam Tandon in TIFR. I did that, and to my surprise and delight, Shyam agreed to move over from TIFR, from a well-established institute, to something which was budding, which showed promise but had nothing at the time in the by way of conveniences. But he moved and took part in leading the instrumentation program. So when I mentioned this to my scientific advisory committee, Professor Radhakrishnan, who was a member of the committee, said that if you have got Shyam, then you don't have to worry about anything. So that is sufficient tribute to what Shyam has done for us. So I would like to end by saying thank you both to Shyam and Naresh.